Hello everyone. So last class we were discussing about analysis of continuous beams by Kani's method. So one problem we have solved. Let us solve few more problems on continuous beams by Kani's method. So I hope you have understood the procedure. So ultimately you can analyze beams or frames by four steps. So first step, you will be finding the friction moments. Second step, you will be finding the rotation factor at the intermediate joints. Third step, you will be drawing the Kani's boxes to find the rotation moments, that is by iteration table. Then lastly, you will be finding what are the support moments, nothing but final moments. Okay, so let us consider the similar type of problem where I have considered the last supports are again fixed. Support A is fixed and support D is fixed. On AB span, there is a UDL of intensity 25 kiloNewton per meter. Then on BC span, there are two concentrated loads acting. On CD span, there is a triangular load, that is uniformly varying load of intensity 75 kiloNewton per meter, and EI is constant. Okay, let us solve this particular beam problem by these steps. Step one, you will be identifying the fixed end moments for different spans, correct? So I'll be writing that MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB, MFCD, MF DC, correct? So fixed end moments are nothing but you are treating each span as fully restrained, and you will be applying the load. Due to this load, what will be the fixed end moments developed? Okay, this load is making the beam to sag downwards, so your fixed end moments will be resisting that, they will be walking, correct? So this is MFAB and this is MFB. Okay, so we are considering clockwise as positive and anti-clockwise as negative. So MFBA is anti-clockwise, MFAB is anti-clockwise, and MFBA is clockwise. So MFAB is minus, MFBA it is plus. Okay, so what is the value? That is formula to calculate the fixtions for UDL, WL square by 12. So this is plus WL square by 12. Okay. So if you substitute the values, W is 25 kiloNewton per meter, span is 6 meters. So ultimately you will be getting, this is minus 75 kiloNewton meter. So this is plus 75 kiloNewton meter. On BC span, there are two concentrated loads, correct? So you are aware about this. If a concentrated load acting at a distance A and B, that is eccentric load, then fixed end moments will be, this is, let us say, MFAB, this is MFBA. So this is WA B square by L square. Similarly, MFBA is WA square B by L square. Correct? So this formula you are aware. So, but here two concentrated loads are acting. So let us apply the same formula by this for 50 kiloNewton separately and this 50 kiloNewton load separately. There are two concentrated loads. I will apply the same formula and I will calculate the effect of these two loads by adding what is the ultimate fixed end moment. Okay, like principle of superposition I'm applying here. So first I will apply only this 50 kiloNewton load and apply the formula to calculate MFAB and MFBA. Then I will apply this 50 kiloNewton load. Again I will calculate what is MFAB and MFBA. So total will MFAB and MFBA are addition of this effect plus addition of this effect, that is principle of superposition. Okay, so for this 50, so it is something like this. This is for first 50 kN load. So this is A is 2 meters and B is 4 meters. From here to here it is 2 meters, from here to here it is 4 meters plus second 50 kN. Now from here to here it is 4 meters and remaining is 2 meters. Correct? So we are applying principle of superposition. Okay, so if you write this, okay, let me rub this first. Let us find this for in detail. So what is MFAB here? That is minus W, that is 50 into A into B square by L square. So for MFAB in this figure plus in this figure MFAB, that is W into A into B square by L square. So actually you are finding this is B, this is C, this is B, this is C. MFBC, WA B square by L square plus WA B square by L square. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 66.67 kilonewton meter. Minus 66.67 kilonewton meter, that is MFBC. Okay, this is MFBC. Similarly, if you apply the same thing to calculate MFCB, what is the formula? W A square B by L square plus W A square B by L square in this figure plus in this figure. So ultimately you will be getting, that is MFCB as 66.67 plus 66.67. Okay, then MFCD. So there is a uniformly varying load, that is triangular load, to calculate the friction moment. So the formula where zero position is there, about that end you will be getting WL square by 30. So this is minus. If you simplify this, you will be getting minus 40 kilonewton meter and MFDC. So here at the maximum end, you will be getting formula plus WL square by 20. If you substitute the values, you will be getting plus 60 kilonewton meter. So these are the fixed end moments. So one thing what you can observe here is MFBC, that is minus 66.67, MFCB, it is also plus 66.67. So you are getting the values similar with opposite sign only if the loadings, these two concentrated loads, are same magnitude. Okay, if they are different, you could have got this different and this answer is different. Okay, so step one is over. So you will be getting the fixed end moments for different spans. So once you get the fixed end moments, now second step. Step two. You need to find rotation factor. Like distribution factor, you are finding the rotation factor where you are finding at intermediate joints. Where at a particular joint, two members or more than two members are meeting. So here joint B as intermediate joint and joint C as intermediate joint, because B is related with VA and VC. Similarly, C is related with CB and CD. It is connected with two spans. Okay, so it is intermediate joints. So as we solved in previous problem, so you have to first make the tabular column. So first column is joint, then second column is members, third column it is relative stiffness, fourth column it is direct level, right, relative rotation factor, that is u is minus 0.5 k divided by summation of k. Okay, if you want you can make one more column here to calculate summation of k. So if you want you can write it here, that is summation of k. If you want you can write it. So ultimately this is distribution factor, relative stiffness divided by summation of relative stiffness. Okay, the joints, intermediate joints are V and C. Okay, so with respect to B, the members are BA and BC. BA and BC. With respect to C, CB and CD. CB and CD. Now relative stiffness. So with respect to joint, the next support that is fixed end, if it is fixed or continuous, relative stiffness will be I by L. So here I is constant, so it is I by 6. Similarly, with respect to B, C is continuous support. So why it is continuous support? After this, one more support is existed. Okay, so we can say it is continuous support. So again, it is I by L, I by, so again, it is 6 meters. Similarly, with respect to joint C, you are finding CB and CD. C to B, it is again continuous because after this, one more support is existed. So I'll say again I by L. So with respect to C, support D is fixed. If it is fixed, again it is I by L. So for CD, it is I by L is 4 meters. So now simplify, you can calculate this summation of K here, summation of K here. Then ultimately minus 0.5 times K divided by summation of K. If you do this, you will be getting minus 0.25. This is minus 0.25. So this is minus 0.2 and this is minus 0.3. So ultimately what you can observe here is at a particular joint, the sum of rotation factor is minus 0.5. Similarly here, sum of rotation factor is minus 0.5. So you should get minus 0.5. So in case of distribution factor, you got 1, correct? So here it will be minus 0.5. Okay. So this is second step where you will be finding the rotation factor. So the rotation factor depends on the relative stiffness and you will be finding at the intermediate joints. With respect to a particular intermediate joint, the next support, if it is fixed or continuous, it is I by L. If it is simple, roller or hinged, then it is 3/4 of I by L. And if it is overhand portion, it will be 0. Correct? So once you find this, then step 3. Step 3, that is iteration table. Nothing but you will be drawing the Carney's boxes. So these Carney's boxes are drawn at the intermediate joints. Correct? So let me draw in the similar fashion. So from here to here, this is intermediate joint. You'll be drawing two square boxes from here to here, again beam. Then this is intermediate joint, that is C, This is fixed. So it is important to note down this final or last supports, which type of supports they are. So this is fixed. So this is also fixed. Instead of they are fixed, if it is something else, then we need to make some operations, because so at the last support, if it is simple ruler or hinged, then moment about that particular support will be zero. So we need to do some operations. So here we need not to worry, because the last supports are fixed. Okay, moment exists. Okay, so now this is joint B, this is joint C, this is A, and this is D. So as we discussed in last problem, so you will be writing the friction moments on top of this horizontal line, so near to the support. So here MFAB, so it was minus 75, MFBA plus 75, MFBC minus 66.67, this is plus 66.67, then MFCD minus 40, and MFDC, it is plus 60. Okay, so these are the fixed moments written near to the supports or joints. Okay, then inside the square box, you will be adding the fixed moments. So here and here. So if we add MFBA and MFBC, so with respect to joint B, the members associated are B to A and B to C. Is MFBA plus MFBC. So that is 75 minus 66.67. If you add it, so you will be getting 8.33. So this is 8.33. I hope it is visible. So similarly here, this is 66.67. This is minus 40. If you add it, so it will be 26.67. It is 26.67. That is the summation of friction moment at a intermediate joint. So from this span and from this span. Okay. Then these boxes will be used to write the rotation factors. Okay. So B to A, B to C, C to B, C to D, the rotation factors you have calculated. B to A, it is minus 0.25. I will write it here. That is minus 0.25. So this is also minus 0.25. B to A, B to C. Similarly, C to B. So it is minus 0.2. CB, it is minus 0.2. CD, it is minus 0.3. Okay, these are rotation factors. So this will be used when you solve the problems for frames. Correct. So now once you draw this Carney's boxes or iteration table, so then you need to find the rotation moments. Okay. So already we have discussed the formula to calculate rotation moment. So for iteration values. So first you need to go on writing this trial number one. Trial one. So let me write the rotation moment formula again for your reference. So rotation moments M dash is equal to rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments. Okay. So M dash is the rotation moment is equal to rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus far end rotation moments with respect to a joint, which are the far end moments. From that, what will be the rotation moment? Okay, trial number one you are doing. So ultimately you will be finding, so M dash B to A, M dash B to C, similarly M dash C to B, and M dash C to D. M dash C to D. Okay. So M dash B to A, that is for BA, BC, CB, CD. Those are the rotation moments from intermediate support you are calculating. So first, B to A, rotation factor, that is minus 0.25. Minus 0.25. Fixed moment at a joint, that is 8.33. Plus, with respect to joint B, the far end rotation moments. With respect to joint B, far ends are A and C. From A, this is initial, so it is 0. From C, it is also initial, first trial, so it is 0. So I will be writing 0 here. So simplify this, you will be getting rotation moment. So if you simplify, you will be getting minus 2.08. Similarly, now M dash B to C. So again, this is the rotation factor U for BC, 0.25. So you are writing again at B, B to C, B to A, you will be using the same fixed moment, that is 8.33. Plus again, from B, the far ends are A and C. From here 0, from here 0. This is first trial. If you simplify this, again it is same. No changes. Minus 2.08. Okay. Similarly, M dash C to B. Okay. Now you are writing at C joint, that is intermediate joint C here. Okay. CB and CD moments you are calculating. Okay. CB, the rotation factor minus 0.2. The fixed moment at C, it is 26.67. Plus far end rotation moment, summation of far ends. With respect to joint C, the far ends are D and B. From D, it is 0. From B, so yes, you have calculated here, already they have come. So I will be writing M dash BA here, B to A here, that is minus 2.08. So similarly here, it is minus 2.08. So now the value had already come. Okay, I will be using that here. So I'll finding CB. From C, the far ends are D and B. From D, it is 0. From B, it is minus 2.08. I'll be writing that instead of plus here, minus 2.08. So as good as whatever the value comes here, so you need to use here. Okay. So minus 2.08. If you simplify this, it is 4.92. Okay. That is M dash CB, C to B. 4.92. This is initial value. So let it be 4.92. So last dash CD, that is rotation factor minus 0.3. Fixed moment at a joint 26.67. So then again, from C, the rotation moments for from ends. So this is 0. From here it is minus 2.08. So again, if you simplify this, you'll be getting minus 7.38. So I'll be writing here minus 7.38. Okay. So these are the rotation moments for trial number one. So you need to go on doing this exercise till you get successive rotation moments similar. Okay, because there are two intermediate joints, then you will be having 3 to 4 trials at least. Okay, if it is only one intermediate joint, then with only one trial only you will be getting what will be the rotation moments, because there will not be again subsequent exchanges. Okay, so let me rub this such that I will be writing the values. So now trial number two. Okay, same M dash BA, M dash BC, M dash CB, M dash CD I'll be finding. So let me rub this, because these values are going to same, correct? Because you cannot change this rotation factor and also fixed moment at a joint. They will be same. Minus 0.25, 8.33. So here minus 0.2, 26.67. Minus 0.25, 8.33. Minus 0.3, 26.67. They will not be changing. Okay. They will remain as it is. Okay. So let us start again. M dash BA. This is second trial. This first trial is over. So second trial, m dash b, rotation factor minus 0.25, friction moment at a joint 8.33, then summation of power end rotation moments from this power end A, power end C. From A is 0, from C one value had come, that is from trial number 1, that is minus 4.92. So write that, minus 4.92. Similarly, so B to C, so again minus 0.25, minus 0.25, friction moment at a joint 8.33, then again rotation moments from far ends. So from here it is 0, from here it is minus 4.92. Minus 4.92. Okay, similarly here, minus 0.2, 26.67. So from here, the value whatever you will get now, that you should be written here. So first, simplify this. Just check how much you are getting. Trial number 2, minus 0.85. So this is also minus 0.85. Okay, so now m dash cb. So minus 0.2, 26.67. Then from this, the power ends, that is from d 0, from this minus 2.08, it was in first trial. So once you get, strike it out because you are in now second trial, that is minus 0.85. Minus 0.85 here, minus 0.85 here, that is in second trial. So now you need to use this minus 0.85. Minus 0.85. Similarly for CD, same, minus 0.3, 26.67. Rotation moment from far ends, minus 0.85, from here it is 0. That is minus 0.85. Okay. So simplify this, you will be getting minus 5.16. This is minus 5.16. So this is minus 7.75. Minus 7.75. Okay. Let me write these values. This is minus 5.16. This is minus 7.75. Okay. I hope it is clear. So this is trial number 2. So once it is over, then again strike out. So these values. Okay. So here also, just for your reference, you can strike out. So the previous value, you need to use it. So you, whether you, while writing trial 3, strike out, or else this is over, you can strike out. But you should be knowing which value you need to consider. Okay. So again, let me consider trial 3. Okay, m dash ba minus 0.25, 8.33. So far ends. So now this value you need to consider, minus 5.16, again strikeout once you consider, or else this is for your reference. So similarly here, minus 5.16, the same procedure. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 0.79. This is minus 0.79. Similarly here, from this, minus 0.79, minus 0.79. Okay, here minus 0.79. So you will be considering this plus this, minus 0.79, minus 0.79. Simplify that, you will be getting minus 5.17. This is minus 7.76. Write that, minus 5.17, minus 7.76. Now you can observe the repetitive successive rotation moments. Here minus 0.85, minus 0.79, minus 0.85, minus 0.79, minus 5.16, minus 0.517, minus 7.75, minus 7.76. So here almost they are same. So here minus 0.85, here minus 0.8 almost. 8.58. So 0.05 is the difference. So you can stop it here, or else if you want to check it again, one more trial, you can do it. So let me write that also. If you get, or else if you do this trial number 4, so ultimately, so if you do this trial number 4, minus 8.33, so this is minus 5.17, minus 5.17, so you will be getting minus 0.79, same value. This is minus 0.79. Okay, so these all our values are in kilonewton meters. Do not forget to write the units. So similarly here, minus 0.79, same values. So here, So you'll be getting minus 5.17, minus 7.76, minus 5.17, minus 7.76. Now you can check it. These values will be same. Okay. So once you get the successive rotation moment value same, then you can stop it here. Okay. Ultimately, you can consider these values as your final rotation moments. Okay. To calculate final moments, that is support moments. Okay. So step number 4. So final step, that is step number 4. So this is not required. So let it be. I will write it here because these values are required for me to calculate the final moments. Step number 4. Final moments. Okay. So final moments are given by with the formula fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moments plus 1 time far end rotation moment. Okay. So with respect to your slope deflection equation, you can write this fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. So yeah, suppose if we are finding MAB, MA to B, so fixed end moment MFAB, that is minus 75. Plus 2 times near end rotation moment. For A, the near end is this. The far end is from B here. The rotation moment at A is 0 near end plus from far end, it is this, the final value, minus 0.79. You need to consider this, minus 0.79. So simplify this, you will be getting minus 75.79. Minus 75.79 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MBA. Okay, MFBA here, sorry, MFBA is minus plus 75 plus 2 times near end is this, no, far end is this. In the same span you are doing MAB, MBA. So always it will be happening in the same span. MBC, MCD, MDC. Okay. So now MFAB is this. You have considered this. Now you are finding MBA. So MFBA plus 75 plus 2 times near end is this now. Far end for B, it is A here, 0. So this is minus 0.79 near end plus far end is 0. If you simplify, you will be getting 73.42. 73.42 kilonewton meter. Okay, so once you get this MAB, MBA, so next. So I'll be writing MBC. So should I write it here? MBC, B to C, MFBC, it is minus 66.67 plus 2 times near end. You are doing in the BC span now. Near end is minus 0.79. Plus far end is this, that is minus 5.17. Simplify this, you will be getting 73.42 minus 73.42 kilonewton meter. Okay. Similarly, MCB, C to B, this side, near end is this, far end is this. So MFCB, it is 66.67 plus 2 times near end, minus 5.17 plus far end, minus 0.79. Simplify this, you will be getting 55.54 kilonewton meter. 55.54 MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, these are over. So now left out with MCD and MDC. So let me rub this. That is MCD, C2D, MFCD minus 40 plus 2 times near end, that is minus 7.76 plus far end, it is 0. Similarly, MDC, MFDC 60 plus 2 times near end, here it is 0. Far end, that is minus 7.76. So if you simplify, you will be getting minus 55.52 kilonewton meter, and this is 3.24. Okay, so these are final moments. Okay, MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, MCD, and MDC. So some are positive, some are negative. So here clockwise moments we have considered as positive and anti-clockwise moments we have considered as negative using appropriate sign convention. So next you need to consider this entire beam. Using your engineering mechanics, you need to find the reactions and you need to draw the shear force diagram and actual bending moment diagram. Okay. So I hope this is clear how to find the moment. Once if it is clear, then let us draw the shear force diagram and actual bending moment diagram. Okay. Okay, so let me draw the bending moment diagram first. So let me write the values here. MAB, so it is 74.79 minus you got, so it is anticlockwise 75.79. MBA, it is clockwise 73.42, and MBC again same value 73.42. So next, MCB 55.54. This is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, 55.54. Correct? MCB is plus 55.54. MCD is minus 55.54. MDC, it is clockwise, 52.24. If you got positive value, then it is clockwise. If you got negative value, then it is anti-clockwise. So first put these brackets, then write down these moments, whatever you have got. So once you write these values, then, so let us draw the actual bending moment diagram. So as we discussed in last problem, the actual bending moment diagram, it is the superposition of free bending moment diagram and support moment diagram. The free bending moment diagram depends on the type of load acting on the span. So we'll be drawing that by considering simply supported beam. And the support moment diagram, so whatever the values you got, MAB, MBA, MBC, depending upon that, you'll be drawing the support moment diagram. So usually the free bending moment diagram will be positive because you will be considering the simply supported beam and you are drawing. So always you'll be getting the positive values, and support moment diagram, it will be negative diagram. Okay. So let me draw the free bending diagram first. So AB, so UDL is there, so parabolic, so WL square by 8, here 2 concentrated load, so something like this, and this value, they are W into A, W into A, so this is cubical, something like this. This variation due to load is cubical because it is UDL. If it is UDL, this is parabolic. Here it is cubical. Okay. So the values, if you find, let me check the values. So here it is 112.5. So this is 100. So this is more than this. Okay. So let me draw here only. Okay. Then this is 2.308 and maximum we are getting some value. Okay. So just check with this. I don't have the answers here. So maximum you just check with. You'll be getting the maximum from this. That is 0.577 of L. So nothing but 2.308 meters. Okay. So this is also called as cubic parabola. Okay. So I don't have the value here answer. So just check with how much you are getting the final. So then support moments, that is 75.79. So this is posterior diagram, these all support moments are negative. So I will be drawing with single line. So this is 75.79. So 73.42. So less than this with a straight line, this is negative 73.42. So here 55.54. Again here this is 55.54. Here 52. So that is 52.24. So then join these values. Okay, something like this. So these values, these are the superimposed figures. So here plus, here it is minus, and here it is minus remaining. Okay. So where your bending moment diagram changes its sign, that is positive to negative, that is nothing but points of contraflexure. You will draw the elastic curve and you will show them. Correct? So elastic curve, it is just deflected shape of the beam. So here fixed ends. So here directly the deflection will not start. So slightly away from that. Something like this. You need to show the points of contraflexure on these points. Correct? These are points of contraflexure. Okay. So this is your elastic curve and this is your actual bending moment diagram. Okay, please calculate this maximum value. I don't have here the answer. You just check it. Okay. So this is with respect to actual bending moment diagram. Okay. So once you get this actual bending moment diagram, then you need to draw the shear force diagram. To find the reactions, you need to use engineering mechanics, that is equations of equilibrium. Okay. So how to find the reactions? So if it is a continuous beam, so after first support, at second support, cut a section. So means, so you are cutting here exactly at B. So this is B support, you are cutting at B support. Okay, here you are getting RA. This is the only unknown. This is 25 kilonewton meter. And these are the moments, correct? So that is 75.79. So here it is 73.42. Okay. So considering a section on left hand side, cut a section left side if it is clockwise, from right side if it is anti-clockwise, then they are positive. This is the sign convention you are using, correct? So cut a section left hand side. You are cutting a section at B, left hand side. So take moment about B equal to zero. If it is clockwise positive, RA is making clockwise. So RA into 6 meters, then this moment is anti-clockwise. So minus 75.79, this is clockwise, plus 73.42, then this UDL minus 25 into 6 into 6 by 2 is equal to zero. Simplify this, you will be getting RA. So if you simplify, you'll be getting around 75.4. Kilonewton. Okay, so then similarly, let us cut a section at C now. Here, consider right hand side. Cut a section at C, consider right hand side. This is B, nothing but RD. So this is UVL. This is C, correct? The moments, this is 55.54 and this is 52.24. So now take moment about C equal to 0. Cut a section right hand side, anti-clockwise positive. Cut a section right hand side, this is anti-clockwise. So let me write it here. RD into 4 meters. So then this is anti-clockwise, so plus 55.54. This is clockwise, so minus 52.24. Then this UDL, triangular load, it is clockwise. So minus half into base is 4 meters, height is 75. Correct? Into perpendicular distance from here to here. That is 2/3 of 4 equal to 0. So simplify this, you will be getting RD. This is RA, what you got. So RD is, you will be getting 99.18. You will be getting 99.18. 99.18. Okay, RA is known, RD is known. So from first support, you have cut section here, you got what is RA. Then from last support, you have cut a section, you got what is RD. So now again, either you can cut a section here, you can consider entire thing right hand side, or else you can cut a section here, entire thing left hand side. So at any point, if you cut a section, so ultimately it will be in equilibrium, correct? So let us write this. Okay, so RA it was 75.4, RD you calculated 99.18. Okay, so next let us cut a section here and consider entire thing right hand side. Okay, cut a section at B. Consider entire thing right hand side. So this is RC. RD already have calculated 99.18. This is yeah, 75 kilonewton per meter. And these are the moments. Then here two concentrated loads. 50, 50, 2, 2, 2. This is 4 meters. Then these are the moments, correct? MBC, how much it was? MBC, 23.42. This is 55.53. So here it is, 55.26 DC. Yeah, just check it. Whatever the answer you got, the moments, the same value you consider. Okay, so now cut the section right hand side. You are taking the moment. So from right hand side, it is anti-clockwise and positive. Okay, take moment about B. Okay, so just check with this moment values whether I have written correct or no. MBC 73.42, correct? This is 55.54. Okay, so MDC it is 52.24. 52.24. Okay. Yeah, 52.24. Now, if you take moment about B, so start from this 99.18 into perpendicular distance is 6 plus 4, it is 10, correct? Plus RC into 6, then this plus 73.42, this moment 50 plus 55.54, and this is minus 55.54. And this is again minus 52.24. So clockwise, both are minus, minus. This is anti-clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, plus, plus. Okay. So then due to load, it is minus 50 into 2, minus 50 into 4. So UDL again, minus half into base is 4 meters into height is 75. Okay, so it is acting somewhere here. From here to here, this perpendicular distance we want. From here to here, it is 6 meters. From here to here, it is 2/3 of 4. This is 6 meters. So total it is 6 plus 2/3 of 4 equal to 0. Correct? So now simplify this. You will be getting how much is RC. If we simplify, you will be getting RC as 97.5. You just check with the answer. Okay. So how much you are getting? So it is somewhere around 97.5. So maybe one kilonewton less than that also, because I don't know correct answers. Okay. So 97.5 kilonewton. So once you get this RC, so then you need to calculate one more reaction, that is RB. Okay. RC is 97.5. Okay. So one more reaction, this RB. How to calculate? Now apply sigma V equal to 0. So RA is upwards plus RB is upwards, RC is upwards plus RD is upwards. These all the reactions, upward reactions, then the loads downwards. Okay. So UDL 25.6. 25 into 6, then minus 50, minus 50, these two concentrated loads, then this, that is half into base into height, 75 equal to 0. Okay. RA 75.4, then RC 797.5, this is 19.18. So simplify this, you will be getting RB. So it is 127.58. 127.5 kilonewton. Okay, these are the reactions. The procedure is same. You just check with calculate again and check with the answers. Okay, so once you get the reactions, then you need to draw the shear force diagram. So you need to start from left side. So ultimately it will come and meet zero at D position. Or else you start from right side, it will come and meet exactly at point A, and that is at zero position. Upwards positive, downwards negative, you consider. Okay. So just I will draw the nature of the diagram. You just do that. Okay. So RA, it is upwards. So 75.4. So from here to here, it is UDL. Whenever you come across the UDL, the total load is 25 into 6. Okay. Then your diagram changes its sign from positive to negative. Correct? So 25 into 6, so minus 75.4. So the diagram, it changes sign. The variation is linear. Okay? So some value will be here. That is 25 into 6 minus 75.4. So RB, so 127.5, already you held down by something. So do that. 127.5 minus the value, watch how much you are down. So you'll be getting this from here to here, a load, no load, straight line. Then 50 coming downwards. Okay, from here to here, no load, straight line. 50 again coming downwards. Maybe you are coming downside. So from here to here, no load. Then 97.5. So again, you will be coming upside. Okay, then again, once you are here, okay, from here to here, that is UVL. So whenever the uniformly varying load is there, so your shear force diagram, again it changes its sign. The variation, it will be, if it is UDL, it is linear. If it is UVL, it is parabolic. Okay, so you might be getting the diagram something like this. It is parabolic curve, that is parabola. Okay, so exactly, then again RD will come and meet here zero. Okay, so this is SFD. You just check with the values here, how much you are getting 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 here. That is your assignment. You need to do it. Okay, this is how you are going to draw the shear force diagram, just variation. Okay, total load minus how much you are here. So this is parabolic for UVL, parabola, you need to understand. So here it is linear for UDL. Okay, this is shear force diagram. So again, similarly, the bending moment diagram already we have drawn. So let me write this. I hope from strength of material already have done this. So when you are drawn the, so here the variation is cubical. The maximum value, this is m is equal to 0.06415 WLU square. So I just remembered. So when you draw this, the maximum value for this UVL, that is 0.06415 WL square. W is 75, L is 4 meters. Substitute, this is maximum. Okay, so that maximum will be from here to here. How much I said? That is 0.577 L. So something 2.308 meters I said. Okay, this is maximum. So maximum moment you can calculate like this. Okay, this is with respect to the problem continuous beam where the last supports are fixed supports. Okay, so let us continue with 2-3 more problems where I will be considering the end conditions different. Okay, one is with overhang portion, one more is with simply supported beam. Okay, let us solve few more problems in further classes. Okay, thank you.